Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. Vice President Mike Pence spoke to employees on July 6th at our Kennedy Space Center in Florida, highlighting the public-private partnerships transforming the center into a multi-user spaceport and changing the way we do business in low Earth orbit.
Extending our nation's leadership in space is one of the greatest challenges of our day. And just as we have risen to the challenges that came before, so too we will rise to meet the new challenges that lie ahead.
Acting Administrator Robert Lightfoot and Kennedy Director Bob Cabana accompanied the Vice President on tours of several facilities currently being leased by private space companies. The tour showcased hardware, systems, and infrastructure that will soon facilitate U.S.-based astronaut launches and eventual missions to deep space. On July 3rd, our astronauts Jack Fisher and Peggy Whitson released the SpaceX Dragon cargo spacecraft from the space station for its return trip to Earth. The 4,100 pounds of cargo returned by Dragon included science samples from human and animal scientific research, biotechnology studies, physical science investigations, and education activities. Whitson and Fisher celebrated the 4th of July on the station by snapping photos while decked out in stars and stripes. It was one of several space-related milestones of note on the 4th. These included the 20th anniversary of the Mars Pathfinder and Sojourner rovers landing on the Red Planet, the one-year anniversary of our Juno spacecraft's arrival at Jupiter, Space Shuttle Columbia's 1982 landing at Edwards Air Force Base, attended by President Ronald Reagan, as well as the 2006 launch of STS-121, the second Space Shuttle program return to flight mission, and our Deep Impact spacecraft's encounter with Comet Tempel 1 in 2005. More than $200,000 has been awarded to teams of citizen inventors that have completed the latest milestone in our 3D printed habitat challenge, a joint effort of our partner Bradley University and several corporate sponsors. The challenge seeks to advance the construction technology needed to 3D print sustainable housing solutions for Earth and beyond using recyclables and simulated Martian soil. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.